Well, maybe we're in a simulation right now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, seriously.
You look at our computing power today, and you say, I have the power to program a world inside of a computer. Well, imagine in the future where you have even more power than that, and you can create characters that have, for example, free will. And I program in the laws that govern that world. Now, you're a character in that world, and you think you have free will, and you say, I want to invent a computer. So you do. Hey, I want to create a world in my computer. So now you lay out all these universes and throw a dart. Which of these universes are you most likely to hit? The original one that started it, or the countless simulations, the daughter simulations that unfolded thereafter?
Vsauce. I'm Jake, and we are living in a simulation, or at least that's what the simulation hypothesis proposes, that if a civilization, a post-human civilization, were to become significantly technologically advanced, then we would most likely be simulated. There are two worlds, two realities. The primary world, which is where the simulation is being run, and the secondary world. The simulated universe we occupy, which to us is the only one. And when creating this world, there are three steps to successfully making the user believe it to be real. Immersion, absorption, and saturation. Think about video games like Age of Empires, Civilization, or The Sims. They're about recreating or mimicking reality, reliving past events, or creating new ones. And in 20 years, we went from games looking like this to this. As visuals advance, as the experiences become more immersive and digital characters start reacting seemingly on their own, our understanding of what is real and what isn't starts to blur. Now, characters in a video game are bound by a set of rules, a set of defining laws. A sim can't walk through a wall even though it isn't actually. It's just lines of code that define what is or is not solid, but it's still called a wall.
Now, think of our own world. This is a collection of atoms that together form an object that we call a wall. It's been atomically programmed to form a specific shape. We are left with something that looks like, that feels like a wall. We don't see the microscopic pieces that build it, just like we don't see the code in a game. We just expect it to act a certain way because of how our world is designed. We trust that this is made of something physical, not just a programmed artificial boundary.
When someone comes to your house, how do they get there? Do you see them leave? Do you see them on their drive? They leave their home, time passes, and there they are. It's world gestalt, a structure or configuration of details which together implies the existence of a world and causes the audience to fill in the missing pieces of that world based on details given. If I walk off frame left, you'd imagine I'd come back around. But if I come back from somewhere unexpected, your perception of reality has been minutely fractured. It's that world gestalt, the assumption of how things should be that allows a simulated reality to function. Not everything needs to be rendered, needs to exist simultaneously for every user in the simulation. Maybe the reason the universe is expanding and growing is that it hasn't finished loading yet. Think of VR. If you are looking in front of you, what is behind you isn't necessarily rendered. It hasn't become real. It isn't until you turn your head that it comes into existence. And what was just in front of you is now gone. So the question becomes, how do you know anything exists when you're not looking at it?
It's the technological version of solipsism, the idea that only your own mind is certain to exist. Everything inside of this frame, the person animating it, the office they're in, the entire world around them, including you, might not exist outside of my own mind.
So let's say we are in a simulation. Why would someone or something do it to this scale in the first place? One of the reasons to run a massive simulation like this is proposed by philosophy professor Nick Bostrom in his paper, Are You Living in a Computer Simulation? He states that it could be an ancestor simulation. A civilization wanted to see what those before them had done, like a history book, but instead of it being read, it's being acted out. Or we could just be characters in an incredibly advanced video game. In our simiverse, we would be the Sims, and in this universe, we even get to play our own very rudimentary version of simulation games on computers, in consoles, thinking that we are in control. And in video games, graphics improve. They get better with our technology, but they don't need to be perfect. With virtual reality, we know that what we are looking at isn't real, but to our senses, to our mind, it is, and we react accordingly. So in this version we live in, it seems real to us because this is all we've known. But to those that program this simiverse, reality could be much different. It is Plato's allegory of the cave.
Plato suggests that you have prisoners chained in a cave from birth, not able to look at each other or anywhere besides directly in front of them at a wall. All they see are shadows projected onto the wall by a fire they've never seen behind them. This is all they've known, so to them, the shadows are reality, and the voices they hear are from the shadows as well. Since they've never experienced anything else, never seen a real person, had a human interaction, they have no understanding of the outside world or the world at all. And if a prisoner were to escape and leave the cave, they would be so frightened and confused by what they saw that they would choose to come back to the comfort of their cave, of their reality.
And just like the prisoners in that cave, what we see in front of us, we believe to be true, believe to be real. The difficulty in deciding if what we're in right now is real life or simulated life is what NYU professor David Chalmers said, that any evidence that we get could be simulated. And there is one important distinction to make. We are not in a virtual world, a world that exists independent of us actually being in it. In that scenario, we are players in a game and there is a flesh and blood version of us somewhere controlling this. That is not the case with this idea. We are in a simulated world, which means we are not users, we are not players. We are simulated as well. As Philip K. Dick said, fake realities will create fake humans.
So why would anybody think that the universe is simulated? Actually, we have five assumptions for you. If they're correct, then you, dear viewer, are simulated.
So follow me into a different reality over on Kurzgesagt. And as always,
thanks for watching.